Hi everybody, welcome to another Corona tutorial. This one will be focused on interior Godrays, basically utilizing Corona's volumetrics to create some nice Godrays effects. But this tutorial won't be just about that, it will be a complete scene creation from scratch. Basically that means that I'll be showing you modeling, shading, lighting and setting up the volume, and then some quick and dirty post-processing. I won't be sharing the scene this time because of the copyrighted textures I will be using. Maybe next time I will try to negotiate some deal with some of the texture sites, and I will attach the scene again, but this time I'll be using quite a few textures, and those are all copyrighted, so it would be not okay to share them with you. This is not going to be really a follow step-by-step tutorial. It's going to be more about adapting some of the workflows I'll be showing you and incorporating them into yours. It will be divided to several phases or several parts, first of which is this one, which is focused basically just on the theory. We'll be looking at some of the things to keep in mind while you're building a scene that will have some pronounced volumetric effects. Alright, so the second part will be a quick sped up modeling overview. It's basically just recording of how I model the scene. I will be doing some commentary on the background and explaining you some of the tools I used and some of the tricks that you can use on your projects later on. Then next part will be shading phase, where I will be showing you how to utilize, for example, Corona ambient occlusion to create some nice weathering effects, as well as doing weathering effects using vertex color. I'll be showing just the regular workflow that I would generally use to shade a scene from scratch. Then another phase will be lighting and volume fog, which is basically we will set up lighting and we will set up volumetric fog, and last phase will be just quick and dirty post-processing phase. So once we go through all these parts, we should have basically final scene. Alright, so next thing I want to talk about is getting good condition for strong and defined Godrays. Basically, oftentimes people will just try to throw the volumetric material in their scene, and they won't really get any good looking results, because to get really really strong and really obvious and pronounced Godrays, you need to set up the right conditions for in your scene to achieve this effect. So first important condition that you should establish for nice Godrays effects is, especially for interiors, a dark interior with quite small openings for light to enter. So you get a nice contrast there, and you get a sharp, strong light coming through very small openings, and that will generally produce very significant and strong Godrays. Next important thing is not too much ambient light in the interior, like artificial light sources or strong overall skylight. By that I mean artificial light sources. If you light up a lot of things inside the interior, they might completely dampen the effect of the outside light that will create the Godrays, or the strong overall skylight where you have your environment map is as strong as, for example, as strong as your key light, and it will you will get just basically washed out bloom rather than sharp sharp strong Godrays. Ideally, you should also have some really sharp and strong key light, such as Corona Sun or HDRI with sun disk captured properly with correct bracketing. The smaller and stronger light source is, the sharper the Godrays will be. And lastly, you should have light direction going roughly against the camera, not from the camera, but against it, So you basically see the effect if you are looking from in the same direction as light is shining, then you will not see pretty much anything. Maybe just some slight features, but it would not be a really strong effect. Next thing I want to talk about is good setup for interior Godrays. For the fog or for volumetric material, we'll be using Corona volume material. There's global volume material slot. That's the first thing you may think about using, but it's a bit problematic because you don't clearly define where the fog ends, and usually you have just small room inside a huge volume that goes maybe several miles on, and most of the light, like sunlight, will scatter a lot before it will reach the window and eventually the room. So I would, for interior, if you want to get really nice, sharp, crisp Godrays, I would not use that. I would not use global volume material. Instead, I would use some simple geometry with Corona material, Corona volume material applied to it. And that's generally what we want, because then we can really control the extent of the volume. For example, if you have old dusty room, like some old workshop, then probably dust is going to be only inside of the room, and outside behind the window it's going to be just clear air. So that's the best way. Unfortunately, there's one limitation. Currently, Corona does not support camera inside of the volumes unless you use global volume material. If you use just the geometry with Corona volume material, then once the camera is inside the volume will stop working. This can be worked around by simply placing the camera slightly outside of the volume. It's a little bit more tricky for animations where the camera is moving. You have to kind of model the geometric path inside of your volume, inside of your volume geometry. There are some ways, but it's generally a pain in the ass, but it's possible and it will work, and this limitation should be removed quite soon in the future. Next thing you should set up when you want nice crisp Godrays is a single bounce in volume material. It renders a lot faster when you enable it. At the same time, it will scatter only direct light, so you will get a lot crisper, a lot sharper Godrays from the volume material. If you get too much light bouncing around, indirect light bouncing around in the volume, it will get all bloomy, and the Godrays will not be so obvious. Of course, if you keep single bounce off, it's more physically accurate. But usually if you are after Godrays, then you want the effect to be slightly exaggerated. So in this case, this is a win-win scenario because it's faster and it looks better for the use of the Godrays. If you do something like clouds, for example, then it might not pay off so much. But if you do Godrays, just some interior fog through which sunlight is shining, for example, then this is ideal scenario. Of course, as I said, it's not physically accurate, but it looks better, it renders faster. Next thing, if you enable single bounce only, basically what you're scattering in the volume is just direct light. So if you have a noisy volume and the rest of the scene converges quicker than that, then the parameter to increase is not as much increase GIAA multiplier, but it's better to increase, first try to increase light samples multiplier, because that controls sampling of the direct light and even scattering of light inside of the volume that has enabled single bounce only is mainly controlled by the light sampling multiplier. Don't overdo it though, because if you set light sampling multiplier too high, like say over 8, then you might steal too much sampling from the rest of the scene, like GI or anti-aliasing, and you might mess up the convergence of your scene. Last thing to do when you want a nice and pronounced Godrays is to slightly increase the forward directionality or anisotropy of the volume scattering. By default, volume material is isotropic, that means directionality of zero. And if you enter positive volume, then light scatters slightly more forward. If you enter negative volume, the light will scatter more backwards. Since we will be having scenario where the light source is shining against our camera, then we want more of that light to come through to the camera. Therefore, increasing directionality to something like 0.25 is ideal. Again, don't overdo it. The more anisotropic the volume is, or the more directional it is, the harder it is to render. So I would say, even though it allows to go from -1 to 1, I would generally suggest you keep it between -0.5 to 0.5. And next thing I want to talk about, I finally drank some water. There have been some remarks about the voice quality of my last tutorial. I have to admit, I was doing like fifth or sixth attempt at recording it, and it was really, really late in the evening, and I was quite tired, so my voice may not have been the best, but I've incorporated the feedback of the audience, and I hope the tutorial quality will improve in the future. Also, for the shading part, I haven't prepared anything in upfront. When I was doing strawberry tutorial, I first tried it out. I tried if all shading worked, and then I basically did again what I did previously. But in this case, I did not. So that part may take a little longer. Hopefully, it won't stretch up for like 2 hours, but it will be a little longer because I will be trying out some stuff, and there's always some tweaking involved. There's like almost never it happens that I would be happy with everything on the first try, so I will be maybe trying some things out, so please be patient. And so it's because when I was working at the studio, I did mainly digital environment. I did not do much of the strawberry close-ups, so I've kind of tried it before I made tutorial, but I'm fairly confident that the shading of this room, which we will be doing, is quite straightforward, at least for me, so it should not be much of a problem. All right, so this is it for the theoretical part, and I'll see you at part 2 where I'll be showing some of the modeling that I did. Okay, so see you later.